Talk to me about a client you've helped. I don't know. I said, well, you don't help clients? He said, of course I do. I said, tell me about one. All right, Robertson Blinds. I said, what happened with Robertson Blinds? Tell me about it. He said, well, what happened with Robertson Blinds was, well, it's about 2.5 years ago now, and we were called in to intervene in a situation. They were in a factoring agreement at the time. Cash flow was on its absolute backside, and there was a huge amount of stress going on at the top end. They were experiencing some seasonal difficulties with the business personally, and what we did was, and outlined his solution, which was nothing more than the technical competencies you've already got applied in a very specific way. It was a case of cash flow forecasting. It was a case of management accounts. It was a case of restructuring his factoring position. And I said, what happened? He said, well, what happened was they got out of that factoring agreement and they got into a situation where they were able to do this, and that funded that, and he's got his boat. He's got his boat? I said, yeah, he always wanted a boat. That's the point. That's why I started the Robertson Blinds. He really wanted a boat, lifetime dream. I said, what does he do with the boat? He said, he sells it, you idiot. I said, I know that, but how big a boat, where? And told me all about the boat. I said, right, so in other words, your intervention equaled accomplishment of lifetime ambition, is that correct? He said, I like it when you put it like that. I said, right, so communicating your value, Alex, is taking where you found your client at the time when you came in, looking at where you've taken them to in the time scale, and the difference, the improvement, is your value. Communicate those stories. Because to be different is good. To be superior in the moment when the client needs it is the diamond standard.